Great God and Father, we pray for your Spirit's presence in this place today. Come close, God. Overshadow and oversee the affairs that will take place right now in this moment in time. We pray your blessings not only on the service, but on the lives of these, your two children, who have come to say, I do, forever, before God and this cloud of witnesses. We thank you for being here today.
My bride, I can hardly hold myself together. Day, this night, I see you as you are, and I never want to leave.
I went to visit a friend of mine one day, and he had a little sign on his refrigerator, and actually it was a napkin, and the napkin said, happy wife, happy life. My wife asked for one of the napkins, brought it home and stuck it in our refrigerator. So every time I go to the refrigerator to find something to eat, I see happy wife, happy life. There's some truth to it, but the other truth is that both of you need to be happy people. You have to be a happy man. You have to be a happy woman. Your happiness cannot be solely dependent on the other person. You have to come to this thing a happy person yourself. And then when you get married, all we're doing is embellishing, enhancing what we both bring to the table. That's really what Paul is talking about in Ephesians chapter 5 when he talks about submission, when he says, wives, submit to your husbands. Husbands, love your wife. You don't have to fear about submitting if he's not holding back on loving. If you're loving and you're submitting, your marriage will be heaven on earth. You will indeed experience true joy, true happiness,
no
and true fulfillment
words
in life.
From my lips, just a look in your eyes says it all, so much more than I could ever. I won't try. After the sunset disappears, when there's no one around and there's nowhere but here, oh my love, let's keep this up as long as we're breathing. Forget in the world outside of this room, while you're holding me close, while I'm holding on to you. Oh my love, let's keep this up as long as our hearts are beating.
If I were to ask you a question, what's the number one cause of divorce? Most people would say automatically money. But really, the number one cause of divorce is the inability to resolve conflict. And money being the number one conflict issue. But if you're submitted to Christ and submitted one to another, you'll be able to give and take and resolve your conflicts quickly so that you can move on. Remember this. There is what we call a conflict cycle or circle. The conflict begins here, and it circles out. And for the conflict to end, you have to come back, and there has to be closure to the conflict. What happens most of the times is, before you close the conflict loop, the conflict metastasizes into another conflict. And ancillary conflicts take you out further and further out into the deep. And before you know it, one conflict goes unresolved. Then another conflict comes and it goes unresolved. And then you have stacked conflicts unresolved. Let me give you one of the greatest secrets to marital success. Resolve your conflicts quickly. get back to loving each other and enjoying life. Get back to the business of being happy people. Get back to the business of great kisses, warm hugs, awesome, the rest of it. You know what I'm talking about. The privileges of marriage. And so I say to you today, you begin a great journey. If Jesus is the cornerstone of your home, you'll find this journey sweeter and sweeter with Jesus and with each other every day. Don't let folks get in the way. Focus on Christ. Focus on each other. Learn to forgive. Learn to let go. And as you do with your car, you pull your car into the service station on your routine monthly, quarterly, or yearly checkups, all change, and changing your spark plug and tune up, do the same thing with your marriage. Don't you dare miss marriage ministry in this church. Read books, go to marriage seminars, and just like you treat your car, as a matter of fact, treat your marriage better than your car. Don't you dare treat your car better than your marriage. Don't take your marriage for granted. Just like you don't take your car for granted, don't take your marriage for granted. Learn to pour into each other. Build each other up. And you will find every day with honey is sweeter than the day before. Every day with honey, I love her, I love him more and more. Just like you do with Jesus Christ. You've got a cadre here. A marvelous collage of comrades who are praying for you. Who stand as the village to encourage and support you. By God's grace, your marriage will be glorious. We declare it in the name of Jesus.
Assembled of marriage in at least two ways. The purity of gold symbolizes the purity of your love for each other. And the unending circle symbolizes the unending vows which you are taking today, which may be broken honorably in the sight of God only, and I underline only, by death.
Avril&Benzy, this is coming from me, Martha. You know, I've been with you guys for a very long time, and I know how much you love each other. I want to tell you that every single day, remember to recommit yourself to the Lord. As you recommit yourself to the Lord, you will recommit yourself to one another. And remember to trust the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding, and in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path. Congratulations to Benzy. Congratulations to Avril, and may God continue to bless you.
You're crazy and I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections.
Avril and Benzy, I want to thank the Lord for what He's done and will continue doing for you guys. And most of all, I want to praise Him for this day that He's made possible for you guys. We prayed together and God made it happen. And I am so grateful for what He's done. And I pray that you guys grow old together, have babies, and love one another more than ever before. God bless you all.
Give me all.
Gabriella and Avril, when I met you, I knew you were the one for my cousin. You were always well-mannered, and you have such a calm spirit about you. And when you're around, it forces people to be as positive as you are. And I thank you for choosing me as your maid of honor.
Avril and Roosevelt, you guys are great. You guys are awesome. I love two of you. You make each other laugh, and you know what? Your family's funny, my family's funny, so together we're gonna have a funny family, and I like that. I appreciate you guys. I think you're made for each other, and you're so special, and I wish you the best. I hurry up and make me some nieces and nephews. Thank you, and have a great life.